Hi guys, I don't know if I'm live. I've done this after. I'm doing this after a really long time. Hello, hello. Thanks for coming. Firstly, I just want to thank everybody for commenting on the post that I put up, because I know I was getting a lot of comments from all of y'all to come live and to interact, and it's been really long. And I wanted to be able to reach out to you more. You know, it's sometimes we reading all of your instant comments, I kind of lose some of them. So what I've done is I actually done some homework. I've sat and gone through all the comments on my Instagram post that I posted, and I've actually written some of the common ones, like I told y'all I would write, about your experiences, all the things that you've shared, and really thank you so much for sharing all your thoughts and feelings. It was just amazing to read that, to know that everyone's going through the same thing, and to see some of y'all so deal with it so maturely. I think it helped me, and I'm sure it's going to help everyone else. So I'm going to get to it. I'm going to start reading some of the things. It's amazing how there's some things which us, like all of us, are dealing with, like sleep. I'm going to read out a couple of the ones that are talking about how they're having sleep issues right now. Okay. Everyone, hi, but I'm going to go straight into this and dive into this. I'm also going to try and save this video so that if you've logged in a little later, you'll get to see and hear me read out your comments, hopefully. So Dhananjay56_09_ says, my sleeping pattern is with a dangerous emoji, sleeping the whole day and staying up all night. Arnav Patkar26 says, I'm not able to sleep or do anything the whole day. Aru7 says, the thing I experienced is that the whole routine gets beeped up. I'm not saying that word on Insta. I stay up all night and sleep in the day. Do you experience the same thing? Yes, Aru, I've been through that initially as well, where I was sleeping at like 3 in the morning and waking up late, thinking I actually started waking up at like 10 o'clock. Even though my eyes would open at 7, I would procrastinate in bed till about, 10 o'clock, thinking that I'll have less time to spend during the day, until pretty recently I felt like, no, I don't want to. I want to sort of still stick to my routine, sleep on time, wake up early. Even if I'm not getting sleep till late and waking up early, not getting sleep till late, sleeping late, I'm still going to try and wake up early so that I can sort of get that cycle back, which one should do, I guess. We all should do. Nidhi says, I generally love sleeping, but now I'm not able to sleep till 3 a.m., just like what I felt, Nidhi, so I completely understand. I don't sleep during the day, so I keep myself occupied, and I don't want to become an insomniac. So I think that's why we need to kind of get the whole sleep pattern back. Okay, lots of love coming in. Thanks, guys. If you all have anything you want to share about how we can beat the sleep issues that some of us are facing right now, it would be nice to read it in your comments. A lot of love again. Something I stopped doing is stopped having coffee after 3 o'clock. Like, my last cup of coffee was 3 o'clock. And I tried to even work out later so I'd feel tired. I can't sleep because my wife's cousins and family want to play Ludo King. What should I do? Listen, play Ludo King. I love playing Ludo King. I'm obsessed with Ludo King. And it's not bad, actually. Some of these board games make your mind really think, and then you're tired by the end of it and ready to knock yourself out. So why not play Ludo King with your wife and her cousin and her family? Chamunda, today's my birthday. Happy birthday. I hope you have a super duper duper day spending with your loved ones. Stay safe, stay at home. And I hope you're all at home while I'm having this conversation with you all. I'm pretty sure, you know, as we can go right now. Okay, jokes apart. Then one comment that really, really did make me feel a lot was Shivu0219. Shivu's a mom and she writes, nice initiative. Being a mom, I sometimes think how it'll affect our kids' minds. The children, for no fault of theirs, are sharing this crisis and are being asked to stay home all the time. It's like putting them in cages, and I pray for each soul. So do I, Shivu, and it really breaks my heart to think, you know, of all the children who are out there who are kind of still probably processing what's happening and why they're being made to sit at home. What I did do is I asked my mom, because my mom's a preschool teacher and she runs a school. I asked her, I actually read this one out to her, and I said, what do you think? You know, I feel it's so sad. And she's constantly in touch with her parents in school, and she, she told me, but right now what's most important is their safety. And it's important right now that we're all safe, our children are safe. So it's important to just keep them safe at home with you. But while doing it, she had a few suggestions, and I hope they work, because I think, you know, it'll be interesting for you and for them. She says, in Montessori activity, in Montessori, they make them do a lot of activities which help their motor development, like folding clothes. If you're probably cooking, you can put them on a safe place and give them a little dough to kind of get their motor skills going. Make them play with, you know, the dough, fold clothes, clean away their toys, put them back. So I think these little things are all life lessons, which, you know, it's great to, you know, keep them busy, make them learn. And reading, of course, I'm sure you're doing everything, like reading to them, you know, trying to keep their days busy. And I think just make this an exciting time for them. There's a movie called Life is Beautiful. And if you've seen that movie, I think it'll bring a big smile to your face. Maybe watch that movie. And I pray with you that this ends soon so the children can go back and, you know, go down and play. I keep looking from my window and I feel really sad. I have friends who have kids who are probably going through the same thing, and just thinking of how to kind of make it exciting for them at home. So, please do. Surine is getting bored because I don't think he has babies or anything. So we'll move on to the more productive questions now. Ma'am, you can break your workout and steps for small intervals in your body. Okay, see, this is really fast. This is why I cannot ever read all the comments on live. Can I go upper? Yeah. Okay. Tyagi Akshay. Is this my friend Akshay? There's some Tyagi Akshay. Okay, ma'am, you can break your workouts and steps for small intervals and your body will feel tired, and therefore body will feel tired and hence sleep will come naturally if it works for me at least. Yeah, actually working out in the evening is pretty good. Even for me, it tires me out by the end of it. A lot of you all wrote about feeling a little unproductive, and that's something that even I went through. I started feeling like this constant pressure of being productive. But I think right now with what's happening, it's okay not to put that pressure on yourself. And I think we should just enjoy the simple things, take each day as it comes, and not stress about, you know, feeling like I have to be productive. I think it will come to you. That moment will come to you when you want to do something outside. In fact, there are a lot of people who've, written a lot of positive things, like to pick up a new skill, do something that you never thought. I actually have a list. I'm going to share this box with you. Okay. So I had written this on one of my birthdays. It's my 30 under 30 things that I want to do before I'm 30 years old. And I kid you not, I think I've only done two or three things. I'm not going to share this list because it's quite private and it's quite like intimate, but these are the 30 things I want to do before I turn 30, and there's not so much time before I turn 30. So but I'm going to start doing some of them, because I think some of them are possible to do when I'm at home. I thought I wanted to take a course in performing arts abroad, but I thought maybe I'll join an online workshop. I just got a forward today that Harvard is doing free online workshops for, I'm going to post that. I don't know. Let me first find out if it's legit, because there are lots of posts doing the round. But I'm going to post that and let's see if that's true. Then why not? I think do a course online. It's pretty cool. It'll help you learn something new. So yeah, don't kill yourself over it. I think it's okay to feel the way you're feeling. It's okay. You're going to have a few days which are rough, which are not. I'm actually telling myself this, and a lot of people have said the same thing, which kind of like reinforced it while I was almost feeling like, but is it really okay? And then I read some of your comments that really helped me as well. A lot of people spoke about job insecurity, and this is something that I want to read out as well. Men on a Mission said, he just wrote about job insecurity. Arnav Patkar, 26, and Meet Gangani, 7, both said overthinking about the future. Tanam Kasaha says how to deal with unemployment. The Misanthropic Girl says, hey Kiara, I hope you're doing well. I've applied for studying abroad, and due to this situation, everything is over the place. I haven't received an admit, and it's really difficult to hold on to my emotions and my patience. My emotions and my patience all over the place. It's tough dealing with the fact that how uncertain our lives and our careers have become. I think this is something which I really did want to read as many comments as I could about it. It's something that at one point I was thinking about, you know, are people stressed about this? And I'm sure they are. Me too. I don't know when my next film's going to release. We are in a profession where going back to set, we're about a minimum of 200 to 400 people on a set working. So it's not possible for us to start work because safety comes first. But I'm going to read out something which I think answers this beautifully, which again, one of you have written. There is, sorry, please bear with me for a few minutes. But I feel this was just what I needed to hear, and I think it's going to help you as well. Okay. Vikram Singh, 909, says, "Ma'am, where you focus, that energy attracts you. I'm only focusing on positivity and enjoying the company of my loved ones. If we compare ourselves with the vulnerable people, then we realize how grateful we truly are." So I think he's said it just right. I think what we're uncertain about, what we don't have control over, there's no point worrying and putting our focus and energy there. Take one day at a time, finish all the tasks that you have today. Let's make today perfect, and whatever has to happen will happen, but let's just work on today. Stop worrying about tomorrow. I don't think we should, you know, be giving out that kind of energy and that negativity. So yeah, I think he said it really well, and I really wanted to share that with y'all. So it will all be okay, and this too shall pass, like they say. I'm going to read out all the unproductive ones. I'm sure all of you can relate to this one. Oh, okay. Murthy Mama says, "Sometimes did I read out the unproductive ones? Now I'm confused which ones I've read out. I've written so many." Okay. Rohan Sharma says, "Many people are stressing on the fact that you should come out of this quarantine with a new skill or habit. It's good, but I think people should understand that it's also a time to slow down, take a step back, and rethink where your life is going. What are your thoughts about this?" I think, Rohan, that's just what we all needed to hear, because, yeah, I think it's a good time to reflect. And, you know, I think in a way it's like nature telling us just chill, and God telling us stop being in this rat race. Just take a minute to just see and rethink, like you said, reflect on that. The gray-haired kid said, "Over time, I've come to terms that it's okay if I wasn't highly productive during this lockdown phase. I've struggled with the choices of what's next in my career. It's okay if I've not been able to learn a new skill entirely, but I have regard for my own self for having struggled through instability of thoughts, evaluated choices, and ultimately widened my intellect. So it's been okay, Kiara." And I'm glad that's how you feel. I'm glad that, you know, you've intellectualized it and you figured this out yourself. That's the thing, we know the answers. We know that we can get out of it. It's just that we have to act upon it. So yeah, we got this, guys. We'll do this together. You know, let me tell you something, what I was going through. So I know these workout videos and all that, y'all keep, I see some funny comments on them, but I feel in my profession, all of us actors, it's how you breathe. Your workout is just a part of what you do. It's not something that we have to do. But during this lockdown period and during quarantine, I just felt like, I didn't feel like working out, and I just felt super lazy and lethargic. And every time I would go on Instagram and I would see my colleagues post a video, that actually made me think, why not actually? Let me just push myself and get there. And when I did, I now realize it's just that struggle of wearing those clothes and going to the gym or going, now you don't, I mean, you can't, if you have it at home, great. If you can go to your balcony or even, you know, put a mat down and do it on the floor, it's fine. But I just realized it releases these happy hormones that just make you feel good. So yeah, I think sometimes, in a way, thanks to Instagram, it's giving you ideas. Technology is the only thing we have right now to keep us busy, to keep us, you know, thinking, creating, deciding what we want to do. And yeah, so I feel like maybe I wasn't up to it, but thanks to like seeing my colleagues do it and pushed me and motivated me to go back to doing all the things that I was so used to in my life. That's it. Okay, let me read some of these. I'm a crazy fan. Thanks, Arnab. That's really sweet of you. Hi, guys. Hi, and hi. Lots of love-struck faces, smileys. That's nice. You guys want to share anything with the comments? All these comments that I've read out and which I will continue to read out, are actually all there, so you can go and see their comments if you want to. There's a lot of positive stuff that you guys have sent in for each other, which I actually really, really liked. So I think, you know, it'd be great to go. But before I sign off, there's one that I really wanted to read. I think for me, this was my most favorite one. Pranav Jain, 29. Pranav Jain, 29, are you on this chat right now? Can you say hi? Okay, I'm going to wait for a second. If he's there, I don't see him. Okay, well, I hope he sees this later. But he's written something for all of us, actually. And I'm going to read it out. It's a little long. So just telling you all to remember that. Okay. So I don't know who needs to hear this, but I'm going to say it. If you are out there and dealing with anxiety, I want to say this. Dear person, I know it sucks. I know it's scary. I know it's like the undertow is pulling you in, and I know you feel like you are drowning. And I'm sorry that you have to deal with it all. I want to tell you that things will get better soon. But I don't know your story, your struggle. I don't know the severity of your illness, and I cannot make you a patronizing promise like that. But what I can say is at one point, and at some point, you will feel like giving up. But just remember that somewhere in your future, maybe not tomorrow, maybe not day after, maybe not even next year, but somewhere in your future, a day is waiting. And it's a simple, ordinary, and profound day where you will get one little thing right. Like you'll make the perfect meal, or the sun and wind will hit your face in that perfect way that'll make you feel better. Or a friend will tell you a joke that'll make you burst into a laughter. And in that second, on that day, a voice in your head will say, I'm glad I stuck around for this. I will also tell you that day will not last forever. And for every good day, there will be a bad day. Because we will wander between the darkness and the light, and that's okay. When you feel like you are at your weak or your weakest, and you feel like giving up, just remember that you might think you're weak, but there's someone else for whom you're their source of strength. Whether you know it or not, what we have, what we deal with, what we live with isn't always nice and pretty, but it is, you are, and you really should stay. Anxiously yours. Pranav, this really touched me. I don't know if you're here because I was busy reading this, and I don't know if everyone else has read this, but I hope they do. It's in the comments, and I'm going to actually post this. But yeah, you're all totally worth it. We all are, and we're going to get through this. So now again, I'll go back to all these. Your eyes have pain, Kiara? Nahi, yaar. It doesn't have pain. It's actually pretty good mascara and all for y'all. Hi, Preeti. Hi, guys. Yeah, I miss my Preeti days. But Kabir Singh is on Netflix, I think, so you can watch it. What's up, guys? Let's also take a moment to thank everyone out there, all the medical, the doctors, the nurses, everyone on the front line, our police officers, our watchmen, vendors, vegetable vendors, every single person who's sacrificing their lives right now to make sure that we are safe. So this one's for them. Thank you for this love. Thanks, Siddharth Malhotra. I hope you've been watching this entire chat. Rohan Chauhan. Okay, it's damn fast, man. Kabir Singh is greater than guilty. Well, so long as I was in both, it's fine. Okay, Bhatna, hi guys. Lots of love. I should do this often. Every time I feel low, I should just come here and you guys will send me all this love. I want to send it back. Man, your acting and dancing just impressed me. I'm going to face out. Another thing I want to do is take an online dance class. I'm going to put up some video online dance class next. Kiara, ma'am, love from Chennai. A lot of love back. I hope you guys are safe. Actually miss the South a lot as well. Adnan Khan has said, do you remember? No, I don't remember when we met last, Adnan Khan. Why don't you remind me? Okay. Now it's going into the hello zone. My mother has commented. My parents are watching this live from the bedroom because That's what they do. They're a bit obsessed with me. My mother said, "You are so witty and funny." Mama, can you ever say anything bad about me? I don't think so. I never knew. What is this emoji, guys? This hand thing you'll put? Is it like a hi-fi or a spank? I've never known, so I never use it. Are you Sindhi? Yeah, Advani. Deepak Chagnani. Oh, yeah, Sindhi too. Hi, buddy. Hi, I am Sahir from Kashmir. Hi, Sahir. Love from Goa. Thanks, guys. Thanks for sending all the love. Lakshmi bomb ke baad kya plan hai? Bhai, nowadays I'm just thinking aaj ka kya plan hai. I've not even thought so far. Take each day as it comes. Just focus on today. Spank, it's a hey. Oh, sorry, Arjun Kapoor. My bad. It's a hey. Oh, it's a hi. Lots of people are saying it's a hi. Okay, got it. Nice. I'm going to use it again. Every time I say hi to you guys, I'm going to say. Okay, guys, should I go now? Oops, sorry. I want to see if I've missed anyone's. I'm asking you so many questions. Makeup by Lekha, I've not read your questions. They're going so fast. Write it again quickly. Kisne touch kiya? Big fan of yours, Jyoti. Kisi ne nahi touch kiya, Jyoti. Aapke comments ne mujhe mere dil pe touch kiya. Makeup, why are you avoiding? Makeup by Lekha, I'm not avoiding your questions. I haven't read anything, babe. Message. What am I reading? Honestly, I haven't started reading a book as yet. I'm watching a lot of content. But I will definitely try and read soon. Lekha, I miss you too. I'm watching a lot of content right now. Anything you all want to recommend? I'm currently watching a show called Servant, which is on Apple TV. I watched Special Ops, which was really nice, which was on Hotstar. A lot of TV shows. Please Hindi mein bolo na kuch. Bas bol diya. Are you watching Ramayan? No. Should I? What channel is it on? My next Telugu movie, guys, I don't know. I don't think any of us know. I think we have to all focus on today. I'm literally just learning to enjoy today, not thinking about kal kya hoga. My mom says, please pray, may God bless and heal the world. Mom, I'm enjoying reading your comments. Right now we as a family, I'd like to share this with you all. We as a family sit at 7 o'clock actually every evening and pray and just thank God for being healthy. And I think that's something that gives us a lot of peace. So why not? That's what you should do too sometimes. Try it. You'll feel happy. Just wake up in the morning and write things you're grateful for. I think that really, really works. I think it's all in the mind. It takes that one moment in the mind to say, to be happy and feel happy. My mom always says when you just smile, you automatically feel happy. Like you feel happy. Like it signals your brain. So try that. Please sing a song, ma'am. I've been asking so many times. You definitely don't want me to sing a song right now. Trust me. Mera gala baith gaya aaj. Siddharth Malhotra asked me to watch his movies. Sure, Sid. Sindhi mein kuch bolo na aap. You know, I only know one line in Sindhi. And for all the Sindhis out there, may not be very happy if I say only that one line. So I don't know if I should say it, but I'll just say it. Thulli dakki vai means fatty got scared. It's a very silly line and I don't know why I know this. Hey, are you at Vivaria? No, I'm not at Vivaria. Preeti wala acting is very hard, ma'am. Nanki. Okay, guys. There's a lot of love. Thank you for sending all your love. And thank you for writing everything that you all did. There were some really, really interesting comments. And there were some really interesting experiences that you all shared with me. And it really brought a smile to my face. So, in a way, I just want to thank you. You all actually helped me feel more productive, do something that I wanted to do. And, you know, just seeing the positivity on your face has really, really, really made my day. So if anyone else is feeling that way, you can actually go to the comment section on my post where I've requested you all to share your feelings and read what everybody's written. They're just amazing. It's not just for me, it's for everybody. So let's do this again very, very soon. And I had fun chatting with you all. Should I take some more questions? Okay, chal, I'll shout out your name. IG Swarnadeep. Swarnadeep, hi. I hope this makes you happy. Chal, I'll say hi to you all. It's Bikram. I'm assuming it's Bikram, but Bikr 4M. Fancy these Insta IDs you all have. Rishabh Bhardwaj, thanks for sharing your time with all of us. We love you. I love you too. And I actually want to spend more and share more time with you all. And time is all we have right now, so let's spend it together. What am I going to cook today for dinner? I think I might have some fish. What are you going to cook? I want to know. Give me some ideas now. Guys, y'all have any ideas of food ideas, what we can cook and eat? Your hairs are so attractive and black and silky. Thank you. I actually washed it today. I'm so happy you noticed it. Who's this? Shrish Mishra. Thanks, Shrish Mishra. Made my day. What would I do first after lockdown? Okay, Ashwini Adia said make khichdi. Thanks, Ash. That's probably what I'm going to do. Though I have khichdi for lunch. It's the only thing I've been eating these days. What will I do first after lockdown? Coming back to your question. I think we'll still have to phase it in. We're still going to have to practice social distancing. We're still going to need to be a little careful. But I just want to go and give the first person I see a big hug. Maybe if I see you, I'll give you a big hug. Home cooked simple food. Yeah, Tripti Kaur. That's what I love. I love ghar ka khana. Raj Kriku says, ma'am, aapka time kaise ja raha hai? Actually, aaj maine kya kiya? Today I woke out in the morning because I wanted to be all fresh for this live session. I showered, I got ready, I put out some blush on and mascara and some tint on my lips to look presentable for y'all. And I was excited to actually chat with all of you and do this Insta live, and I'm spending my time with you right now. Iske baad, maybe I'll watch some content, I'll hang with my family, make something fun for dinner. Fatsizzy. Okay, these are really interesting Instagram IDs, but thanks for that compliment. Can I borrow your eyebrows? Yeah, sure, I'll just pluck them off and peel them and send it to you. Actually, another thing I learned is how to do my own eyebrows during lockdown. It's very important to know how to do all these things. Have I been to Australia? No, only Soham Kulkarni. I haven't been to Australia. I'd love to go, and I hope it's possible very soon. Things get better and we can travel. But abhi ke liye, everybody stay home and stay safe for yourselves and your loved ones. King Akshay Akash Tyagi. Lots of Tyagis here, but Akash Tyagi, happy birthday. I hope you have a super duper duper day. I Varshu _ Verma, kisne touch kiya? Aap sabne mere dil ko touch kiya. I think it's a very good answer. Again. Sorry, sometimes I like feel very impressed by my own answers, which you might not feel, but I feel. Ramayan dekhte hai kya? Nahi, I think I should start watching. Last Stories 2 kab aayegi? Karan Johar ko ye baat pata hai and Ronnie Screwal. I don't know if they'll make that again. Your favorite movie? I watched a movie called Knives Out during lockdown. That's the only movie I've actually watched during the whole lockdown. It was quite nice. Favorite though, if you ask me, I think it'll be like a romantic comedy. I think Dilwale Dulhania Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. All time. Okay guys. My quarantine crush. My family. They are my quarantine, my forever crush, my forever loves. Okay guys, I'm gonna sign off now. This was really fun. Thank you for coming in. Thank you for chatting with me. We'll do this again, I promise. And stay safe, stay healthy, stay home. And we'll spend our time now that I'm going to be home too. We'll do many more live chats and I'll probably answer many more of your questions. Thank you so, so, so much for coming and sharing this wonderful evening with me. Bye, guys. I'm going, huh? Tata. Okay, I don't know how to end this video. Okay. Bye.